new intro. So much love and appreciation to those of you who have been with me for the 2 year period plus that I've been doing this. Thank you for showing your love and support to the channel. And to anybody else who is brand new to the platform and you would like to support the channel, also you can do it by way of Patreon, Anchor, the clothing store, and also the shoe shop that is listed in the comment description below. And again, thank you to any and all of you guys who have been here to support this channel during the 2+ year period. I wouldn't be able to do what I do every single day without you.
Hear me clearly. America is not a racist country.
We need to adjust. Well, first of all, no, I don't think America is a racist country.
Awkward. Tagalog is a language spoken in the Philippines. Tien, by the way, is Vietnamese. The man who doesn't appear satisfied with Tien's response then starts asking a series of bizarre questions.
What's your favorite charity, homie? What's your favorite charity?
And makes these statements.
I'm sure your marriage is going so well.
And insults.
Oh, look it up on Google. You're a weirdo, dog. You're a creep, man. You're a creep. Pedophile creep. Pedophile creep.
Even cursing in front of Tien's children.
Why can't I answer my simple question?
Because, you know, I can pass, you know, but I'm actually Vietnamese.
This is why he's speaking out, to protect his usually quiet neighborhood.
Whoever this person is, and, you know, I hope that he get caught so that it won't happen again to anybody else. I want to shine light on this, you know, I want to make sure that, you know, it's safe for everyone and safe for my kids growing up in this neighborhood.
Several hours later, to do this.
He came back and, you know, he smashed both of my cars with weights.
This is the weight Tien says he found in between his kids' car seats.
It is scary.
While San Jose police say the incident doesn't appear to be hate motivated, Tien can't help but think he was targeted because of his race.
Have blacks been pitted against Asians?
We need the black community to realize that that black people are hurting Asians and they need to speak out in their own community.
Our communities are not reporting these incidences. We don't want to cause more trouble, more attention to our community.
It strikes me that this is the Asian equivalent of the talk that African American parents often have to have with their children.
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
You know, I just had to put my specs on and a monocle and a magnifying glass, and I had to look at this video quite, tight. I had to get right up on the screen because I didn't spot a lick of melanin in the individual who decided to do Asian hate directly to this Asian family. He came directly at him. He was directly on their property in their driveway. As the kids were there, he was obviously a threat. He was belligerent. He was hollering all type of expletives and other types of words, which, you know, children should not even be able to hear, especially at that age. And he directed a certain type of wording directly to the father, which, you know, made no sense, right? He decided he was driving along the road, and then the father was minding his own business, being with his family. You know, spending time with his kids, doing things that fathers normally do. And this man stopped in the middle of the road, impeding traffic, right? Blocking traffic, right? And he proceeded to get out of his car, leave the car door open, and just wanted to have a conversation with the dad and question him about, you know, is he Vietnamese? What language does he speak? And all these other things. Like I said before, this is yet again another true American. This person ain't black. Y'all tried to sit up there and, oh, you know, all the Asian hated, it had to do with the black people, and it was the black people's fault, and the only reason that Asian hate even exists in America is only solely due to the African-American community. African-American community needs to sit up there and talk amongst their own people. It was even to the effect that you had black people literally jumping on the same bandwagon on TikTok and everywhere else, talking about stop the Asian hate. But yet, all this time in this country that black people have been facing all types of hatred, discrimination, and everything like that, guess what? A lot of minorities were sitting back, relaxing, chilling, drinking iced tea, cool glass of water, lemonade, what have you. They were sitting back chilling because the focus wasn't on them. So they were happy. They were completely fine and dandy with everything that was transpiring, taking place, because they knew at a moment in time, if they decided to lift their head up, and stopped looking at the concrete as they were walking, and they wanted to focus on what it was that black people are going through, that they were going to be the next target. So you know what they did? They were like, you know what? This ain't our problem. This ain't our issue. This ain't our people. This ain't our community. This has nothing to do with us. Well, looky, 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 looky here. Asian community. The very same people that you consider to be your next door neighbors, your brothers, your sisters. The very same people that you bleach your skin in order to look like. The very same people that you worship and want to be shoulder to shoulder with and that you put on a pedestal and that you envision them to be your gods. They're the same exact ones coming directly after you. They're the very same ones questioning you about your flag. Questioning you about the language that you speak. When if you are, if you aren't. It ain't black people because we really don't care. At the end of the day, we really don't. We're not going to stop our cars in the middle of the road and impede traffic. Leave our doors open so somebody can just run off with a car and have a conversation because we're just so interested in the flag that you're flying. We're not going to send threats talking about, oh yeah, if this flag is still up here on your house, you know, I'm going to come up here and I'm going to pull it down. You know what that man did? That criminal did? I'm sorry, I can't call him a criminal because the police don't even want to label him as a criminal. The police said that this is not even a hate crime. So, you know, matter of fact, this is just a man having a conversation with another man. So the other man that was driving that wanted to talk to the other man who just so happens to be a Pacific Islander, Asian American, right? He decided to come back late at night and throw weights into this Asian American's car, tearing up, vandalizing that vehicle. But yet again, police were like, you know what? There's not enough evidence here to have it equal up to a hate crime. Wow, isn't that amazing? All of those laws that were passed, all of that money that y'all got, and it still didn't put y'all on par with the true Americans. It didn't put you on equal footing. It didn't put you on that level. Ain't that something? But yet, somehow, some way, I'm pretty sure that somebody in the Asian community or somebody who is a quote-unquote ally is trying to find out or figure out a way on how to pin this on a black man. Better yet, they're not even going to focus on this. They're going to try to focus on another story where you have a magical black guy or black woman that just so have happened to have said something to an Asian couple or an Asian man or an Asian woman or have, you know, potentially done something physically. They would rather focus on that versus focusing on the fact that it is the global minority who makes up the majority at this point in time in the United States of America that's attacking the Asian Americans, attacking that population. But they want to make it seem like racism doesn't exist. But mind you, if you go back and you research, just Google something for a couple of seconds, and you look up racist photos from the 1960s, 50s, 40s, and so on, a lot of those signs would have no Asians allowed. And they would have other words, which obviously I'm not even going to use here on YouTube because somebody would try to flag the video. But like I said, black people had nothing to do with that. We didn't tell Asians that, hey, we don't want you in our neighborhoods. We didn't tell Asians that we don't want your businesses in our neighborhoods. We didn't sit up there and tell them that we don't want you living anywhere near us. It was the true Americans that were dictating that, showing that, and telling that to the Asian American population. Better yet, that was the same population who put all of y'all into these type of camps, right? Who are holding you in a sense as prisoners because they couldn't figure out if they could trust you or not because of various things that were taking place with China and Japan. It wasn't black people that did that to you. It wasn't black people that was mistreating you. It was them. But like I said, those are your guys. That's who you worship. So at the end of the day, you're willing to cut off your nose despite your face. That's basically where you are at this moment in time. You're willing to suffer any and every type of pain. If that means that you are going to be amongst them on some type of, you know, financial level, on some type of equal footing, because that's what a lot of y'all realistically want. That's why a lot of you guys don't even claim the darker and more melanated of your population. This is why you put them up north in rural areas. This is why if you do have, even look at some K-pop stars, this is why a lot of them bleach their skin. because white is close to right. White is close to purity. And that's what they figure that they want to go to. That's the angle that they're aiming for. Because what has been taught is that if you are dark, you are seen as unclean, you are seen as filthy, and so on and so on and so on and so on and so on. But anyways, I digress. You know, that's enough of me talking. Asian Americans, to the Asian community, what are you guys realistically going to do with all of that money that y'all got and all of these laws that y'all got? Are you still going to allow your guys to mistreat you, or are you going to do something different? That's all I'm asking as a black man who lives in America and that's been going through this along with, you know, the rest of my family, along with my elders, along with black people historically. That's all I'm asking. What realistically, what chess moves are you really going to make now? Or is this, you know, all that there is? But anyways, let me know what you guys think about this video and everything that I stated in the comment description below. And as always, peace, love, and stay tuned for the next video.